Well, attention please. Attention. Put aside your mobiles. Be quiet. Because today we're having a very, very important event in our school. Why? Because this day is the day of great victory of our country. Thanks to our ancestors, I mean your great grandfathers, we are sitting here, we are happy, and we can laugh, we can enjoy, delight our life. That's why today we really consider this remarkable day as the most significant one in our life. Well, now please, I think that in such occasion we won't have to make you behave yourself. And we teachers, that personally, I like you in your future. I'd say near future, in the pursuit of wealth and happiness. Don't forget about your ancestors who did their best in order we could be happy today. The Red Army and Navy and the whole Soviet people might fight to the last drop of blood for our towns and villages, onward to victory.
Tens of thousands like it. Friends. comrades. None can know who among them lived and which ones died. They are the anonymous ones of the unknown war.
Without warning, sparking the start of World War II. By the evening of September 3rd, Britain and France were at war with Germany, and within a week, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, and South Africa had also joined the war. 6 long and bloody years of total war, but over many thousands of square kilometers followed. From the hedgerows of Normandy to the streets of Stalingrad, the icy mountains of Norway to the sweltering deserts of Libya, the insect-infested jungles of Burma to the coral-reefed islands to the Pacific.
Now suddenly all that changed. By mid-July, the Wehrmacht had already covered half the distance to Moscow, Hitler's prime target. The Nazis were jubilant. In less than a month following the road Napoleon had taken, they had come within striking distance of Smolensk, 235 miles west of Moscow. Systematically, they isolated unit after unit of the Red Army. They thought the war would be a short one. Vienna, Prague, Brussels, The Hague, Copenhagen, Oslo, Paris, Belgrade, Warsaw lay behind them. Moscow would be next. In July, the first serious air raids came to Moscow, and with them a growing awareness of danger. More anti-aircraft guns were mounted. And the defenses were dug, the women alongside the men. At Smolensk, the Red Army was fighting with all its strength to protect Moscow. Some German tank crews were attacked so furiously that they could not open their turret hatches. Even Hitler was forced to acknowledge what he called the savage determination of the Russian infantry. The battle in and around Smolensk itself lasted 10 weeks. 10 Soviet divisions were caught in the Smolensk pocket. They made the Germans fight for every city block. It was the heaviest, fastest, most merciless assault ever launched. Through the farms of the Ukraine and Belarusia, heading for Kiev, Smolensk, Leningrad, Moscow, intending the utter extinction of the Soviet state and the Russian people. That was Hitler's plan. Hermann Göring announced, this year in Russia, around 20 to 30 million people will die from starvation. The population of some nationalities have to be reduced. Over their birthright. They were kind to animals for the benefit of the newsreels to be shown back home. Though sometimes it was difficult to find any animals to befriend. months that followed, there would be two possibilities in the event of a German victory. They would be herded to Siberia, or if they seemed Nordic enough, they would be absorbed into Germany. Their land and their goods would belong to the Thousand-Year Reich. The Russian people had no choice but to accept. German tanks on the Volga in the summer of 1942, less than an hour away from Stalingrad. Thus far, the Germans were proud of their achievements at Stalingrad. They hoped to impress Japan's ambassador in Berlin with them. Japanese to fight the Soviet Union. The Japanese were polite, but the answer was non-committal. During the early 1930s, the Germans and the Japanese demonstrated to the rest of the world that they had much in common.
The flower of the nation. Germany needs peace and desires peace.
Who can believe his words?
Now Hitler, in 1944, defend Paris to the last, destroy all bridges over the Seine, and devastate this city. In the same year, we shall solve this problem, and afterwards Warsaw as the capital and the pool of intelligentsia of that nation will be destroyed. And now, his soldiers. In all my years as a soldier, I have never seen me fight so hard. Lieutenant General,
Western Europe. He had blitzed London. But here, in this area, some 16 miles from the Kremlin, and commemorated by these symbolic anti-tank obstacles, the Nazi blitzkrieg came to an end. Here, in the Moscow suburbs, the Red Army and hundreds of thousands of ordinary men, women, and children threw up barriers which the Nazi tanks could not crack. Here, the tide was turned in the unknown war on the Eastern Front. On November 7th, as always, the Soviet Union celebrated its national holiday. Stalin addressed the troops in Red Square and then watched as Red Army units paraded past him through the snow and onto the front. In early December, the Red Army counterattacked. They pushed back Hitler's armies as far as 125 miles from Moscow. It was the first time in the Second World War that the mighty Nazi Wehrmacht was stopped. Our story, the battle.
Took part in the war. It involved the mobilization of over 100 million military personnel, making it the most widespread war in history, and placed the participants in a state of total war, erasing the distinction between civil and military resources. This resulted in the complete activation of nations' economic, industrial, and scientific capabilities for the purposes of the war effort. World War II involved every major world power in terms of losses in human lives and material resources. World War II
was undeniably the most destructive military conflict today. Over 60 million people took part, over 60 million people, the majority of them civilians, were killed, making it the deadliest conflict in human history. The financial cost of the war is estimated at about $1 trillion worldwide, making it the most costly war in capital as well as lives. World War II killed more people, involved more nations, and cost more money than any other war in history. Most of Europe and big parts of Asia lay in ruins.
World War II cost the United States 1 million casualties and nearly 400,000 deaths. In both domestic and foreign affairs, its consequences were far-reaching. It ended the Depression, brought millions of married women into the workforce, initiated sweeping changes in the lives of the nation's minority groups, and dramatically expanded government's presence in American life.
World War II casualties of the Soviet Union are all related causes, and commonly estimated in excess of 20 million, both civilians and militaries. Also, the statistics vary to a great extent. The current accept by Russian government is that total losses were 26.6 million both civilians and the militaries, with militaries dead of 8 and 7 million.
It was not that there was no sympathy for the Soviets. British workers took to the streets to show it. Soviets sent an unusual ambassador to New York to beg friends. A sniper, she had killed over 150 Germans.
And this is Lieutenant Ludmila Pavlichenko. Ludmila is 26 years old. Her mother and father gave her a sound body and a good mind, and trained her to be a social worker.
Я хочу сказать вам, что мы победим.
I want to say that we shall overcome, because there is no force that can interfere with the triumphant march of free nations. We must unite. As a Russian soldier, I give you, great American soldiers, my hand.
Fellow soldiers, forward to victory!
Lord Beaver, British Minister of Production.
Soviets and one half of the overall losses were about 25 million people, plus or minus 1 million. Then America can indicate 8.7 million military deaths. This is actually the lower limit of the official figures understated for losses and combat partisan deaths. Excess civilian deaths in the Nazi occupied USSR were 13 and 7 million persons, including 2 million Jews. There were an additional 2.6 million deaths in the entire regions of the Soviet Union. The authors maintain scope for error in this number is very wide. At least 1 million perished in the wartime Gulag camps or in deportations. Other deaths occurred in the wartime evacuation and due to war related communication and disease in the interim. In short, the general picture of Soviet wartime loss suggests a jigsaw puzzle. The general outline is clear. People died in colossal numbers, but in many miserable and terrible circumstances. But individual pieces of the puzzle don't fit well. Stephen Rothschild.
The war also imposed severe material losses on the Soviet economy. The destruction included 6 million buildings that previously housed 25 million people. 31,850 industrial establishments and 167,000 schools, colleges, hospitals, and public libraries. Officially, these losses were estimated at one-third of the Soviet Union's pre-war wealth, being that only 1 in 8 people died. It follows that wealth was destroyed in higher rates than people. Thus, those who survived were impoverished.
Soviet Union regained all of its territorial borders and invaded Germany, and it's ended. The war in Europe was ended with the capture of Berlin by Soviet and Polish troops, and subsequent German conventional surrender on 8 May 1945. During 1944 and 1945, United States defeated the Japanese Navy and captured the West Pacific islands. And the invasion of Japanese archipelago became imminent. The war in Asia ended on 15 August 1945 when Japan agreed to surrender.
Ich liebe mein Land, die Sorge darum, ob alles uns auch gelingen wird. Jedes Jahr mit Liebe und Schweig uns beide ein gutes Stück.
Good afternoon, dear pupils and teachers. We are the students of the Agintsova Institute for the Humanities, and we are glad to see you here today and to participate in your event.
The 9th of May is the date of victory in the Second World War, which was the great patriotic war for all the Russians. It is the day of military honor of Russian armed forces. Parades, festivals and shows took place far and wide in Russia. This day is its tragic history too. About 11 million of people, of military people, and 9 million of peaceful population perished during the war. When the Great Patriotic War started, hundreds of people from Agintsova took part in the war. All the town plans began to work for the army in the front. On December 1941, there was the last attack of German fascists on Moscow. The enemies were 12 kilometers northwest from Agintsova, near the Moskva River, but they were defeated. Many soldiers didn't return. The town's memorial reminds us about them.
Thousands of soldiers and ordinary people were awarded by the title Hero of the Soviet Union, which is the highest distinction in the Soviet Union. Of course, much more than 11,000 people fought heroic for their motherland, but they remain unknown for us. Not only men fought for the freedom, but also women showed themselves courageous, with strong will and character. There are 87 heroes of the Soviet Union among women. Our young generation, we, our brothers and sisters, still remember and honor the memory of the aged generation and the old fallen heroes. In memorial of all of them, some years ago we created a film about the veteran, our countrywoman who took part in the Second World War. Let's see the courage and the bravery this great woman showed.
Начало мая в красной гвоздике, как слезы тех далеких страшных лет, и ветеранов праведной лики, особенно которых больше нет.
Когда опять подходит даже лето, я почему-то чувствую вину. Все меньше вспоминают о победе, все больше забывают про войну.
Граждане и гражданки Советского Союза, советское правительство и его глава, товарищ Сталин, поручили мне сделать следующее заявление. Сегодня в 4 часа утра, без предъявления каких-либо претензий к Советскому Союзу, без объявления войны, германские войска напали на нашу страну, атаковали наши границы во многих местах и подвергли бомбежке со своих самолетов наши города Житомир, Киев, Севастополь, Каунас и некоторые другие, причем убито и ранено более 200 человек.
В день Великой Победы над фашистской Германией мы вспоминаем ветеранов, их героические подвиги, их бесстрашие перед лицом врага и многочисленные заслуги перед Отечеством. Многих из них уже давно нет живых. Мы должны с трепетом и уважением относиться к тем ветеранам, которые еще с нами. Хочется поговорить с каждым из них и записать их воспоминания, чтобы жизнь этих героических людей могла стать примером для нового поколения. Речь пойдет о мужественной женщине, которая прошла всю войну от начала до конца и решила поделиться с нами воспоминаниями о своей жизни в военные годы.
Когда началась война, Клавдии Павловне не было 20 лет. Молодая девушка окончила училище и была студенткой второго курса института. Она должна была стать учителем математики, но война изменила все планы. Нужно было возвращаться в родное село Путило Ленинградской области. Но она была разрушена. Две школы, детский сад, несколько домов. Все было уничтожено во время бомбежки. Дом Клавдии Павловны тоже был разрушен. Сестра была ранена, а папа в больницу погиб в результате бомбежки. Жить было негде, поэтому девушке пришлось идти к знакомым. Вскоре она встретила девушек, которые служили в воинской части, и молодая девушка решила пойти добровольцем на службу в советскую армию, защищать родную землю, свою Гатчину от фашистских захватчиков. За время войны Клавдия Павловна сменила несколько должностей. Она была вольно наемной по горючим смазочным материалам, служила в штабе, охраняла самолеты и даже была стрелком по вооружению. Последние годы она работала в тылу. К концу войны Клавдия Павловна получила звание младшего сержанта гвардии, два ордена Отечественной войны и многочисленные медали за боевые заслуги. Во время войны Клавдия Павловна познакомилась со своим будущим мужем, Логиновым Борисом Александровичем.
Логинов Борис Александрович – уроженец Московской области. Родился в многодетной семье. В семье было 9 детей. Родные братья Бориса Александровича во время войны тоже защищали свою родину. Не все из них вернулись домой. Борис Александрович закончил Качинское летное училище, служил летчиком 32-го авиационного полка. Он летал на самолете, подаренном авиационному полку коллективом театра имени Вахтангова. Известный писатель и поэт Константин Симонов в годы войны был военным корреспондентом, часто посещал их авиационный полк, встречался с боевыми летчиками, писал о них очерки. Во время войны Борис Александрович проявил себя как настоящий герой и патриот своей родины. Лично им было сбито 13 вражеских самолетов. Еще 6 самолетов он сбил в группе с другими летчиками. Борис Александрович и Василий Сталин вместе учились в Качинском военном летном училище. В самый страшный период жизни Клавдии Павловны, здоровье которой было подорвано годами войны, она оказалась больна туберкулезом, Василий Осипович Сталин помогал направлять ее на лечение в военный санаторий, в котором Клавдию Павловну вылечили от страшной болезни. Если бы не помощь Василия Сталина, неизвестно, как бы сложилась ее судьба.
9 мая 1945 года вся страна узнала о великой победе над фашистской Германией.
Победу как вы узнали, вот Павлович? Победу, да, вижу, у нас страшно, да? Ой, девчонки, победа. Мы тоже не под Москвой.
Александрович, трое детей, два сына и дочь. Сыновья посвятили свою жизнь авиации. Старший сын Виталий Борисович Логинов стал военным летчиком. Младший Юрий Борисович стал авиационным военным инженером. Лариса Борисовна, дочь, закончила педагогический институт. У Клавдии Павловны 4 внуков и 6 правнуков. Сейчас Клавдия Павловна живет в поселке Новый Городок Одинцовского района Московской области. Она живет с дочерью. Бориса Александровича уже давно нет живых.
Вспоминая военные страшные годы, когда она служила стрелком авиационного полка, она также вспоминает всех боевых подруг и товарищей, которые погибли в те годы. из 19 молодых летчиков Скачинского училища, которые прибыли в полк вместе с Борисом Александровичем, встретили победу только двое.
Клавдия Павловна – одна из тех немногих ветеранов, которая может нам поведать о тех героических подвигах, которые совершали советские люди, защищая свою землю, свое отечество. Но с каждым годом этих людей становится меньше.
Так давайте не будем забывать о них, ведь многим из них нужна помощь. Мы должны чтить и уважать тех, кто привел нашу страну к победе. Они достойны того, чтобы их помнили, чтобы ими гордились и были им благодарны.
Все, до свидания.